Hi everyone, this is Nancy with a quick video for designbundles.net, and today we're going to be looking at how to create a knockout design in Silhouette Studio. I'll be using version 4 of the software for this tutorial, and you can see an example of a completed knockout design in front of you, and this is the example that I'll be using to show you how this technique works. So for a knockout design, you need two things. You need your image and you need a couple of lines of text. So I'm going to go ahead and zoom out and move this image over to the side, and you can see I have an SVG ready to go for my design. It's a little monster SVG that I downloaded from Design Bundles, and I'm going to just click on it and go over to the fill panel and change the color to the color of the material that I'll be using to cut out my design. With the knockout design, it usually helps to have a simpler shaped image, just so that it's easier to see. And then you can go over to the text tool and type out the text that you're going to use in your design. Another thing to keep in mind when it comes to the knockout design is you want to have at least two lines of text, and you definitely want to use a font that's a thicker or a bolder font. So you can go over to the text style panel after selecting your text and choose your font. I'm going to use Impact, which is just a nice bold font that came pre-installed on my computer. And I'm also going to come down to character spacing, and I'm going to decrease the amount of space between my lines to about 75%. I think that looks better with the knockout design. And then I'm just going to drag my text box until I have my text looking how I want it. Then click on it and again go over to the fill panel and change the color of the text to the color of the material that I'll be cutting it out of. Now you want to make sure that your image is on top of your text, and you can see here that mine is not. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to right click the image and click bring forward. This should put the image on top of your text where you need it, and then you can just resize it and place it where you want it to appear on your design. Sometimes it also helps to just zoom in a little bit and see exactly where the gaps are going to be once you punch that image out of your text. So I like how it looks. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select both the text and the image, and I'm going to need to make a second copy. And I do this by going to Object, Replicate, Duplicate below. Now there are plenty of ways you can create copies in Silhouette Studio, so just use the method that works best for you. You're then going to want to select the first copy, go over to the Modify panel, and click Crop. Now before you click anywhere else in the screen, just right-click what's left behind and go to click Group. This will ensure that all your little pieces stay together. With the second copy, you want to again select both the image and the text, go to the Modify panel, and this time click Subtract. Once again, right-click what's left behind and click Group. Now you've got your two pieces ready to put together, so you can just drag them on top of each other. A couple of tips for making sure that you're getting a really nice snug fit is to zoom in and to just use your keyboard arrows to place your image where it needs to be. Something else you can do is select both the image and the text and go over to the line style panel. And for the line color, just choose a transparent line. This will help you see if there are some gaps in there that you need to deal with. And that's it. Now your design is ready to cut. You can cut it out of heat transfer vinyl, put it on a t-shirt, put it on a bag, or think of some other creative ways to use your knockout design. So thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.